Dear students, part 4 of today's session deals with the potential energy in an external field and the definition of electron volt. Let us see what an electron volt is. The electron volt is defined as the kinetic energy gained by an electron when it is accelerated through a potential difference of 1 volt. That is, if an electron is to be moved from the negatively charged plate to the positively charged plate, and if the potential difference between the plates is 1 volt, the kinetic energy gained by the electron is termed as electron volt. Electron volt is notated as small e into capital V. The kinetic energy of a charge, which when accelerated through a potential difference of 1 volt, which is the electron volt, is given by the kinetic energy Ek is equivalent to charge Q into potential V. We have already discussed work done as charge into potential. Here work done will be equivalent to the kinetic energy gained by the electron. We know the charge of an electron E is equivalent to 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. And here we have taken V to be 1 volt. So, kinetic energy is equivalent to 1 electron volt when charge Q is equivalent to E and V is equivalent to 1 volt. Substituting for E and V, you will get 1 electron volt is equivalent to 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 joule. It is clear from this equation that electron volt is the unit of energy. And 1 electron volt is the kinetic energy gained by an electron when accelerated through a potential difference of 1 volt. In the previous module, we have discussed potential energy of a system of charges when no electric field was present. Now, we are going to calculate the potential energy of a system of two charges in a region of electric field. Let Q1 and Q2 be the two charges located at distances R1 and R2 respectively in an external electric field. Here, we are bringing the charges Q1 and Q2 to a region where already an electric field is present. The work done in bringing the charge Q1 from infinity to the point R1 is W1 is equivalent to Q1 into V of R1, where V of R1 is the potential already present in that region due to the presence of electric field. Similarly, the work done in bringing the charge Q2 from infinity to a point R2 also can be calculated. While bringing Q2, remember that we have to do work against the electric field which is already present and also due to the field produced by charge Q1. So the work done on Q2 against the electric field is given by W2 is equivalent to Q2 into V of R2, where V of R2 is the potential developed due to the electric field at the point R2. Then, work done on Q2 against the field due to Q1 is given by W12 is equivalent to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q Q1 Q2 by R12. This is the case that we had discussed in the last module. Here, R12 is the distance between charges Q1 and Q2. So, the total work done in bringing Q2 against the two fields will be equivalent to the sum of the work done in the two cases, and by the principle of superposition, this total work done will be equivalent to W2 plus W12, which is equivalent to Q2 into V of R2 plus Q1 Q2 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R12. This is the total work done in assembling Q2 alone against the two fields. And we had already done a work W1 in order to assemble the charge Q1, which is W1 is equivalent to Q1 into V of R1. So, the total potential energy of the system, or the total work done in assembling the charges Q1 and Q2 from infinity to a region where already an electric field is present, is given by U is equivalent to W1 plus W2 plus W12, or U is equivalent to Q1 into V of R1 plus Q2 into V of R2 plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by R12. The same case is being explained here. Work done in bringing Q1 alone is W1 is equivalent to Q1 into V of R1. Work done in bringing Q2 alone is W2 is equivalent to Q2 into V of R2 plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R12. Total work done is W1 plus W2, which is Q1 into V of R1 plus Q2 into V of R2 plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by R12. Hope you have understood. Thank you, dear students.